members, you've seen it. Everyone is already on your TV screen and in the news as we speak, including social media. Nigeria's economy grew 1.92% in the fourth quarter of 2017, but much less than 1%, 0.83% for full year 2017. This is Buhari's administration's first post-recession economic numbers. And you've seen some of the, you've heard some of the first words as far as these numbers are concerned. Yes, this is good, but we need to do more. The good news and the bad news. Yes, it was a very roaring fourth quarter, but the full year was soft because a few things that would have to be part of the conversation moving forward with our team assembled here today, tomorrow, and for the rest of the week. Let's bring commodities into this entire conversation with our oil and gas. Our oil refining business in last year was terribly underwater. Listen, look at the numbers if you have got oil refining, other manufacturing was a negative 46.24%. So we oil refining was about 50%, almost 47%, about 46.24% in the red last year. Fourth quarter, that was massively under the water. And that's even worse than the fourth quarter of 2016. And that was 17.70% lower. But for full year, our crude oil production was just 4.79% for full year. Let's get a bit of this into, and of course we're going to throw agriculture, which is one of our bellwethers, and what we're getting from there with Adimo Kwesa, who is one of the research analysts at Financial Derivatives Company. Adim, good morning.
Morning.
Let's get straight to the business. We have a lot to chew.
Yes, indeed.
So the good news and the bad news, as far as the commodity side of these numbers are.
Yes, indeed. I think we have a lot. There's a lot of good news this morning. I think the agricultural sector, looking at the numbers, the agriculture sector grew by 3.45% compared to 4.11% in 2016. I'm sure the public will be confused. They'll be perplexed. Why did the agriculture sector grow faster in recession year? I think the answer to that is because in 2017, we saw severe flooding in June, July, which had a massive impact, negative impact on agricultural output. However, the good news is that agricultural sector grew faster in the second, the fourth quarter of the year compared to the third quarter of 2017. I think this number should encourage policymakers. 2018 is looking like a promising year. These numbers are not likely to affect domestic commodity prices. However, what this will do is that it will send a positive signal to consumers, to businesses, that the economy is on the upturn. 2018 is looking promising. The government has made a lot of progress, has made progress on multiple fronts. For example, regarding our agricultural sector, the Anchor's Borrowers Program has done a lot to boost output, has created over 50 million jobs. Regarding the overall sector, a lot of progress has been made in improving the business environment. The FX market has stabilized, and we're seeing the government pursue radical strategies to boost revenue, for example, the VAT, and even there's even a possibility that it might revive its privatization program. So it's looking like a good year. However, I think 2018 will not come without its challenges. For example, number one, 2018 is a pre-election year. Political considerations are likely to be clouded, physical considerations. I think most people agree with me that political
uncertainty. The administration official says no. The finance minister says no. It's going to be business as usual, and they will not allow politics to override economic management.
But regardless, I think most people agree with me that political uncertainty is even greater this year than it was in 2014. This is likely to most definitely weigh on the economy in some way, or maybe capital reversals.
We're just stepping into the water. Let's see how it looks like. Let's see how it plays out when the parties start having their campaigns, the primaries, and what have you. Let's see what actually, and when the calendar for the elections are finally agreed upon, and see who goes first and whatever. Maybe that we'll just leave it for that. But let's get back to the burning economic issues. Okay. And from your team at FDC, I could see that there's a little bit of a tag there. Hopefully, recession is now over with a 0.83% GDP growth for full year 2017.
Yes, indeed. We've seen three consecutive quarters of positive growth. So technically, we're out of this recession. There's no double dip recession. We're on this positive upward trajectory, so it's very optimistic, it's very promising right now. And I think what should happen is that the government should not take its foot off the gas. I think it should continue to enact policies that will boost to propel the economy, continue to subsidize productive sectors of the economy, for example, agriculture, manufacturing, so that, because it's just a matter of time, the next recession is inevitable. So we need to be able to create buffers that would help us deal with our recession.
Let's move on quickly and look at one of the agri sector. We had a very good crop production under our agri. That's almost a decent 5%, 4.58% in Q4. For full year, crop production grew 3.64%. That's good, even though a little bit lower than 4.34 in 2016. And you think we can do far much better in terms of crops, whether they are wheat, corn, maize, whatever?
Yes, indeed. I think this year, even more so than last year, a lot of progress has been made in boosting domestic output. We're seeing production in wheat, in corn, in sorghum, in rice boost significantly. That is good. That is good news. That has put money in the pockets of farmers. And the hope is that this momentum will be sustained throughout this year and we would even make greater progress in our Greek sector.
I'm looking at our wheat production. There, if you can just pull that up and see where we are in terms of wheat production. Yeah, we're still, in terms of the SSA, we have Nigeria, South Africa, of course, leading in terms of wheat production. You think we can scale up from where we are at the moment, considering the importance of wheat?
We produce a mega 60,000 tons, and this compares to about, let me estimate that 2 million tons of wheat that we import. So we're still some way far from achieving self-sufficiency in wheat production. Our import bill is estimated at $2 billion, which is quite significant. So,
and our production is just $12.6 million.
60,000, yes, exactly. So if we can continue boosting production in wheat, in grains, in other commodities, sorghum, then we'll make a lot of progress, we'll make a lot of headway.